Welcome to Fundamentals of Light and Lasers, Course 1. Today we're going to do Laboratory 1-3A, Irradiance, where we're going to measure the power and irradiance of a laser beam. Okay, let's look at the equipment that we're going to use in this laboratory. We're going to have our safety goggles handy, and we'll have our helium neon laser sitting on top of our lab jack. We have two lens chuck assemblies, which are going to hold our neutral density filter and our diverging lens. We'll have a ruler and a sheet of millimeter spaced graph paper to use to measure our beam diameter. We'll have a photo detector and a power meter that we'll be using. And lastly, we'll have a beam block to stop our laser beam from striking anything that we don't want it to strike.
Let's take a closer look at our photo detector and our power meter. This photo detector we're using here is a silicon photo detector with an ambient light shade, a 1000-to-1 attenuator, and of course the base and rod assembly. Here we have our power meter, which the photo detector is hooked up to. I'm going to turn it on, and when it comes up, I'm going to hit the zero key to make sure we are zeroed. You'll see it start to zero. And we'll check our wavelength, which should read at 633 nanometers. Now we should be ready to receive laser light.
All right, we turned the laser on and Derek has his safety goggles on, and he is lining up the photo detector with the laser. You'll notice that we have mounted the laser on the lab jack, which is also mounted to the optical bench, and he is trying to maximize the power reading that shows up on the power meter. Okay, now that we've got everything set up, it looks like our laser is warmed up and we've got a power reading of about 0.74 microwatts. So on our data table, we'll record a power level of 0.74 microwatts. But remember that we're using a 1000-to-1 attenuator here. So we're going to multiply this power, actual power, by 1000. And our actual power will be 0.74 milliwatts. All right, let's use the neutral density filter placed in the beam path, and being careful of reflections that you don't flash that reflection into somebody's eyes. And notice how it drops the power on the power meter considerably. And now we'll place a piece of graph paper, metric graph paper, in the beam path, and we'll use that to measure the beam diameter. Now it may be kind of hard to see with the video camera, so let me lower the lights in the room a little bit and see if that'll help it so that you can see it with the camera. Alright, now with the lights dimmed, it's a little easier to see the size of the beam on the graph paper. We're using paper that is 5 squares per centimeter. And if I look really close, it looks like the beam is about 2 squares, so that corresponds to about 4 millimeters. So our beam diameter is 4 millimeters. Alright, now that we have our beam diameter measurement, let's go to our data table and calculate our irradiance. So our diameter we measured to be 4 millimeters. But we need to calculate that in terms of centimeters. So we know that is the same as 0.4 centimeters. Now our area calculation is going to be pi times that diameter squared divided by 4. So if we put that number into our calculator and we'll round it to 2 significant digits, we'll get 0.13 centimeters squared for our laser beam. And our irradiance then will be equal to the ratio of the power divided by the area, So we'll take our power is 0.74 milliwatts divided by our area, 0.13 centimeters squared. Put those numbers into our calculator and we get 5.7 milliwatts per centimeter squared. So we've calculated now the irradiance of our laser beam coming out here. For the second part of the lab, Derek is putting the lens chuck assembly into place that's going to hold our diverging lens.
Now one thing you want to do to help you line up this lens with the exact center, since we're using a diverging lens, is you'll look at the reflection that this beam is casting on your laser, and that will help you determine the exact center once you get the laser lined up exactly with the center of where it's coming back from. Then you can tighten it down and we have our beam.
All right, now that we have the diverging lens in position, you'll notice that the beam is spread out, and as the beam block is moved further and further back, you'll notice that the beam gets spread out more and more. And so the question is, where are we going to put our detector at four different positions? We want the beam to be at least as large as the detector area, which we know to be 7 millimeters in diameter. So we're going to use the neutral density filter once again to measure that beam diameter with our graph paper. And to do that, we'll again have to dim our lights. And Derek will place the graphing paper in there and look for a beam diameter that is at least 4 squares, and then we'll start there as our first position. So now that we've replaced our beam block with our photo detector, and our power meter is showing 0.57 microwatts, and Derek, how far away do we have our photo detector from the diverging lens?
I think we have about 19 centimeters.
About 19 centimeters. All right, so in our data table, we'll record at position 1, 19 centimeters, we'll have a power of 0.57 microwatts. Let's move that photo detector back a little bit and measure another power. All right, so now that we've made our measurements for power and at these different distances, we can fill in that data table and do some calculations for the irradiance at the different positions of the detector in this from this laser. The area calculations for this detector use the area of the detector, pi divided by 4, times the diameter of that detector is 0.7 centimeters squared, which gives an area of 0.38 centimeters squared. And to calculate the irradiance at those different positions, we calculate the ratio of the power divided by the area of that detector, just like before. So we measured a power of 0.57 milliwatts, and we divide that by the area of 0.38 centimeters squared to get an irradiance of 1.5 milliwatts per centimeter squared. And when we moved our detector back a little bit to a distance of, in our case, 26 centimeters, then we have a lower power of 0.36 milliwatts, and that yields a calculation of an irradiance of 0.95 milliwatts per square centimeter, and so on. So you can see as you move farther and farther away from the laser and the diverging lens, that the irradiance gets smaller and smaller. All right, so that concludes Lab 1-3A of measuring the irradiance of a laser, a very important skill that you will use often in this course.